Generation 5 is a market research company that offers Conestoga the use of software called Allocate. The software is a very powerful tool that helps you analyze geographic areas, for example, a province, a city, or even areas of a city, for example, postal codes, to understand what types of people live where, including their demographics and expenditures. Generally, you can use it in two ways. To start with a geographic area of interest and figure out what types of people live in that area, or to start with types of people of interest to you and figure out where they are concentrated. This is often applied for direct marketing to discover which postal codes are most desirable to market to. The software is available in the Library Resource Center only. Please ask at the front desk to find out which computers have the software on them. This tutorial will take you through 5 basic steps to creating an output using this software. The first step is pick a geographic area to analyze. The second step is to pick demographic and/or expenditure details of interest. The third step is to choose the file type and style of output. The fourth step is to save your output selections for later use. And the last step is to click Finish to retrieve your statistics. The first decision you must make is deciding what geographic areas you wish to analyze. You can make your selection on the second tab, the Pick Geography tab. You will see familiar types of geographic areas like Canada, province, postal code. You have to choose the best level of geography for your research. For example, you'd use the province folder if you wanted statistics for all of Ontario. For example, if you were asking the question, what is the average household income of Ontario? This will report a single statistic for the entire province. If you wanted to know about Kitchener, you wouldn't choose the province geography, even though it's in Ontario. You'd probably choose the census subdivision category, then find Kitchener within it. Similarly, if you wanted to know where people with the highest household income live in Kitchener, you wouldn't choose the Kitchener census subdivision because it reports on all of Kitchener, not areas within it. In this case, you'd probably choose to select postal codes, and then select all the postal codes in Kitchener, so later on you can observe differences between them and pick out postal codes that best match the type of people you're interested in. There's also the possibility of creating a custom geographic area. This is useful when you're analyzing a particular location, for instance, a business location, to determine what types of people live near it. You can select a circumference around the location and report on the households within it. Take a look at the library's Generation 5 Research Help Guide for more details on this. The second step is to choose an output type. There are two possibilities: file or report. There's rules to choosing which to use. If you're looking at 25 or less geographic areas, for example, individual cities or individual postal codes, you'd use the report option because it looks nicer. Otherwise, you'll have to use the file option. Because we've already selected postal codes amounting to many more than 25, we'll choose the file option in this demonstration. It's important to make sure you're saving as an Excel file. The third step is to choose your variables. The word variables basically means the characteristics of people that you want to know more about. There are several categories to consider. The base attributes category includes very basic demographic variables, like the total population, total households, population by sex, etc. The Canadian Attributes folder includes more detailed demographic variables, including age, income, family type, etc. The Canadian Segments folder is a little unique. Generation 5 provides segmented customer groups on which you can report. Each postal code in Canada is assigned a single segment group to represent everyone in it. So rather than selecting a variety of individual demographic variables, you could instead choose one or more population segments which match your target consumer. The resulting statistic displays the number of households, not people, categorized as the selected segment group or type. You can review the descriptions of each segment group and subgroup on the Step 3 page of the Generation 5 guide. Spending attributes. The Spending Attributes folder provides variables on a wide variety of expenditure categories and can be quite detailed. For example, you may report on expenditures related to men's athletic footwear, dinners purchased at table food restaurants, or veterinarian services, or cellular services. There's lots of options. All statistics are in average per household per year format. Unless the variable is selected from a folder labeled aggregate, in which case you receive a statistic that multiplies the average per household per year by the number of households in the geographic area. That latter option effectively provides the market share for the expenditure category. Step 4. Back in Step 2, you created a save location for your statistical output file or report. However, there's a second important save you should make. You have the option to save all these selections that you've made in the previous steps, which is called your workspace. If you do that, you can return and open your workspace design at a later date. This is helpful if you don't have enough time to complete your analysis in one sitting. To save your workspace as an allocate file, use the Workspace tab and select File, then click Save As and choose a location to store the workplace file. Step 5. When you have finished making all your selections on all the other tabs, press the Finish button at the bottom of the Allocate interface. My example used the file format on the Output tab. Because of that, I receive an unformatted file that requires some interpretation. In particular, you will need to retitle the coded column headers using the associated description text file, which will be found in the same place you chose to store your output. Once you've done that, you'll need to interpret the information. Your strategy is up to you. Which postal codes are most desirable for direct marketing of your product or service? Filter and sort the Excel table to narrow the list down. mapping Generation 5 data. As we've seen, Generation 5 can report statistics on geographic areas, but it won't show you a map of the information. One helpful tool is an outside website called Batch Geo. It's free to use. Using it, you can input your Excel spreadsheet of information, and Batch Geo will create a map that shows you where there are concentrations of those postal codes. A warning though, it can take a while to process your file, so be patient. Hopefully this tutorial has helped you understand the power of the Generation 5 Allocate software. Remember, you'll find even more information and steps available on the library's Generation 5 Research Help Guide.